This is it. The teases are over as the Incredibles 2 ad campaign has officially begun in earnest with a massive info dump. So massive that it would lead one to believe that a trailer, an actual trailer, is on the horizon. For the Super Bowl, perhaps, it is a perfect fit as so many families, of course, sit down to watch the big game together. So we're going to go over the character reveals, new characters, and also some interesting plot points that have also been revealed. Oh, it's so exciting. Now, of course, the new movie will pick up with the Parr family in Frozone exactly where we left off. But again, now new characters are entering the mix. And we're actually going to start with Mrs. Incredible because we're finally finding out now why she's stepping up and becoming a more public crime fighter while Mr. Incredible has to stay home and take care of the family and become Mr. Mom. So it says here that Helen Parr, voice of Holly Hunter, by the way, isn't this a beautiful character reveal with the with the key art, right? Almost like the concept design. And some of them look pretty close, you know, with the Incredibles to how they looked in the animated movie. So I hope that the actual character designs are as bold as this concept art. All right, so anyway, with Helen Parr, again, voiced by Holly Hunter, it says, known in the super world as Elastigirl, hung up her super suit to raise the family with husband Bob, leaving their crime-fighting days behind them. But when she's tapped to lead a campaign to bring the supers back into the spotlight, she finds she can still bend, stretch, and twist herself into any shape needed to solve the trickiest of mysteries. Oh, I like that. Not just, you know, punching problems, but solving them. In short, she's still got it. That's good news, too, because a new villain is emerging, unlike any they've ever seen before. I believe it's corporate America, which we'll get to in just a moment. But this is great. So she's not only going to have to fight crime, but be a spokesperson. And I think that'll be interesting as well. You know, you can recall they started out the first Incredibles movie with supers having to do publicity as well. And they had a lot of fun with that, as well as made some great points. All right, so next up, that company, which is headed by a brother-sister duo. And the voice cast here, as you can see, is amazing. Bob Odenkirk and Catherine Keener. Let's start with Bob, who's voicing Winston Deavor. He leads a world-class telecommunications company alongside his genius sister, Evelyn. Ultra wealthy, savvy, and suave. Everything that Saul hopes that he wishes that he was, right, or tries to pretend that he is. Winston goes big at everything he does, including his infatuation with supers. Little shades of Coulson there, so he's a fan. He has been a supporter of supers returning. All he needs is a hero or three to help him change public perception and bring them back into the sunlight. Oh, I think ulterior motive might be here, or maybe a way to profit off of them. You know, for instance, in Batman White Knight, they've talked a lot about how the rich of Gotham had a Batman Devastation Fund, which would pay to rebuild everything that Batman destroyed in his fight on crime, right, as a vigilante. And it was quite a profitable endeavor. Endeavor, get it? The Devers? I just got it myself. Very clever, Brad Bird. I'm so happy for Bob Odenkirk. I don't think he gets enough respect for what he's done on Better Call Saul, one of the best shows ever. Lives up to Breaking Bad. Love it so much. Speaking of Better Call Saul, so I think there's a very good chance, by the way, that the Devers are villains, or at least one of them is. I mean, just look at that design for Winston. It's either he's a red herring or a legit villain. Now, speaking of Better Call Saul, Jonathan Banks also joins the cast. I guess Brad Bird likes Better Call Saul, right? He's voicing, he's voicing a character from the first movie, Rick Decker, who was originally voiced by Bud Lucky, an animator at Pixar, who's still alive. So I'm not sure why he's not still voicing the character. He did a great job in the first movie. Maybe he's retired. Maybe he doesn't. I couldn't find out if he was retired or not. Maybe he doesn't want to, or maybe the role is bigger, so they've decided to get an actor of Jonathan Banks' caliber. And he certainly is a good match with Rick Decker. Now, as for Evelyn, this is great. I think I love Evelyn's character design. I bet at first, at least, she seems like a great friend for Helen, right? A work friend. It's fabulous. And, you know, Helen not only gets out of the house, but she makes a friend and, you know, really starts to have like her own life, her own thing going on, right? In addition to her family, of course. So it says, Evelyn Deavor, voice of Catherine Keener, the brilliant brainchild behind her brother Winston's telecommunications company, knows her way around tech. She loves tinkering with tech and has never met a problem she can't solve. Methinks she might be unaware of her brother's more nefarious business dealings. So that could be potentially a story point. Now, there's one more really fascinating character. We'll save her for last. So next up, I want to talk about Isabella Rossellini's character. Great choice for a voice cast. And that is the dignified foreign ambassador. Apparently, she just goes by ambassador, who is committed to the support and legalization of superheroes. Or so she says. Maybe she used to be a superhero in the past. There could be some interesting things there, particularly with Isabella Rossellini voicing. And then we have a new superhero. This is very exciting. Voyd, voiced by Sophia Bush. She is a young, overeager wannabe super, and I have to be careful not to make it too much like the problem with the first movie, right? But a mega fan of Elastigirl. She has her own stalker. Her superpower is the ability to divert and manipulate objects around her by creating voids that allow the objects to appear and disappear and shift in space. This to me sounds like Blink from Marvel Comics. Blink could open up like, you've seen her also in the movies, of course, most recently, X-Men Days of Future Past. And she's also on the new television series, The Gifted. But basically, she can open up portals, and you can use the momentum of something that's traveling towards you and spit it out in a different location. It's pretty clever, and I think it should be pretty easy to explain to people who aren't into comics, right, as a power set. Now, I think this she could either be an asset to Elastigirl, or perhaps she could be the villain. I mean, you could have an all-about Eve situation, which I think would be very interesting. Again, it's going to be tricky not to have this too much like the first movie. Maybe that Voyd being a villain, but I think it could be interesting as well. I think this is a missed opportunity to have another character of color in the movie, considering, of course, the main family, the Parrs, are already Caucasian. But Brad Bird, there is some diversity here, and Brad Bird, of course, has certainly won everyone's trust. So those are the new characters. Those are some story details. I think we'll probably see them in action very soon. How does it sound to you? Who do you think might be the villain? What do you think of the new characters? What do you think of the actors chosen to voice them? And are you as excited as I am? Write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.